The Philippine Trade Department reminds business owners to be responsible following the Takoyaki store's viral April Fool's prank, which was later revealed to be a social media stunt. Victoria Tulad reports.
While some are amused with the supposed April Fool's Day prank a business owner pulled off last week, where a man ended up getting a tattoo of the business logo on his forehead, the Department of Trade and Industry, or DTI, is not pleased. According to the agency, it is already investigating the possible violations related to this. It doesn't matter if the prank actually turned out to be a marketing stunt hatched last year by owner Carl Keon. DTI Assistant Secretary Amanda Nograles says they will proceed with the probe just the same.
Pag ang DTI nagbigay ng business name registration, dapat gamitin mo ng maayos. Yung business name can be revoked, can be canceled, can be suspended, no? So kapag wala kang business name registration, hindi ka makakakuha ng business permit at hindi ka makaka-operate ng negosyo mo.
On Saturday, Keon posted a video admitting that they hatched the idea in 2023 to become viral. Ramil Albano, the man who had the logo tattooed on his forehead, turned out to be an accomplice.
Noong August 29, 2023, nagpahanap ako sa kaibigan kong tattoo artist, noong meron ba siyang kaibigan na willing magtatattoo sa loob. Noong may sasabak sa challenge, ay handa akong magbigay ng 100,000 piso. Hindi na masyadong tumagal ang paghahanap. Kinagabihan lang, nakahanap na kami. At siya, si Tatay Ramil.
Keon later on apologized. Despite the lies, Keon says, help poured for Albano, who has a son with Down syndrome. The father and son received money and other donations from netizens. But the DTI said that reasoning is not enough.
Bibigyan ba natin ng basbas yung mga ganyang marketing ploy? Kasi parang hindi naman yata tama yan for the protection of our netizens and the general public.
Nograles added that prosecutors may even opt to file a case against those who were behind the marketing stunt.
Iniinganyo ng tao through that post ang mamamayan para magpatattoo. And what is that? That's self-harm. It's humiliation. Parang ipahiya yung sarili nila in exchange for a price.
Be responsible at saka galangin din ang mga karapatan at saka yung dignidad ng ating mga netizens at saka mamamayan.
DTI has also reported the incident to Meta, the parent company of Facebook, for violation of its community standards and to the Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center for possible charges. ABS-CBN News tried to get the side of Keon and his group, but they have yet to respond to our request. According to public relations professional Andy Saracho, whether it was a marketing stunt or not, the act was done in bad taste as it played on people's emotions and needs, particularly money. Saracho said what people want to see is authenticity, something they can relate to and be inspired of. ScamWatch Philippines cautioned the public to be wary of what they see on social media.
Critical thinking dapat natin ang pairali. Kung iisipin mo, mga ganang post, after few minutes, pag-post yung lalaki na meron na siyang tapo, tapos magaling na, di ba? Parang alam mo talaga na may kalupuhan na nangyayari. Hindi po masama magduda tayo sa mga nakikita natin. At saka na tayo mag-decide. Huwag magpapadala sa emotion natin. Tutulong kagad tayo. Hindi natin alam saan pala yun.
Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.